Today, we will test another Schumann frequency generator, whether it is a scam or whether it works. Welcome to the lab. In another video, I tested this Schumann frequency generator and I was a little disappointed. I will put the link in the description. And after a while, I said, why not looking at the newer version? Yes, and they made something good in it. So we will check this out today until the roots. Are you ready? Get a cup of coffee and enjoy. And let me get my headphones because I had another device before. And as soon as I plugged the headphones in it, the waveform completely destroyed. And this cannot be. Okay, this is just to see whether the sound is okay. Because the newer devices, they say they have a really wide frequency spectrum. And they even deliver audio noise. It's just sound. It's not the electromagnetic wave that we need as a Schumann frequency. But it's nice to have. And when I put the headphones in the other device, it completely destroys any resistor, destroys the waveform. So this doesn't work. And we want something better, not something worse. Therefore, this is my new version. And it seems quite promising. So let's dive in. As this device also has a wide frequency spectrum, this can serve for quite a bit. So let me put, we have something for the display. We can put it on, off. This is nice. They say sine wave. Is it a sine wave? We will test this out. Here's the headphone socket. So now it's set to 7.83 Hertz, the Schumann frequency, but we don't want this. First, we make a test. So we have these small switches here. Let's go to the normal frequency, 440 Hertz. As a musician, you know this. Okay. It's not quite accurate, but at least it says what it's doing. This is good. 440.14. So let's put in the headphone to see and to hear whether we really have a clear sine wave. We can hear this. Good. This is a pure sine wave. We will check this even better with the oscilloscope. Sounds nice. So we can bring it back to the this. The good thing is we have a reset button. When we put the reset button, it makes a complete reset and it goes back to the Schumann frequency. Okay, we have it 7.83 Hertz. And there's a small LED blinking. This is always blinking at the peak of the sine wave. Let's make a check. For example, we make a frequency just 1 Hertz. 1 Hertz. Okay. You see, it goes like a second. 1 Hertz means one vibration in a second. And when we go to 2, same thing. 2 flashes in a second. So let's go back to the Schumann frequency, 7.83 Hertz. So this means in 1 second, it's flashing nearly 7 times, 7.83 times. And I think before we go into the measurements, let's check the quality, because the manual said they go to 30,000 Hertz. And there was another description that says they go to 100,000 Hertz. So let's make the test. And they said they go from 0.1. This is amazing. We don't need this, but it's good to have. So let's check this out in the manual. They say they go from 0.1, but we can even start 0.02. It's good to have. Nobody needs this. And now let's see the maximum. 999999. Okay. So it says 100,000 hertz. This means with these small switches, you can put any frequency. For example, 0.9. Yes. Or when you need a 1 kilohertz reference tone, 0.111. Now we have 1,000 hertz sine wave. Let's check the sine wave. So far, it looks quite good. I prepared a little plug here. Okay. And I can put the oscilloscope on it. Okay. And now let's go back to the Schumann frequency. Okay. 7.83 hertz. And now let's check it. Okay. We have it produces a sine wave, at least when we put the headphones in. So let's make a check. This output at least brings a sine wave. This is the negative. This is all the same. So let's check the coil, because the coil is producing the electromagnetic waves, hopefully. Yes, it does. Exactly. Not only this output, but also the frequency goes directly in the coil. And the other side, same thing. Okay, yes, both coils are fed with the frequency that we can read on the display. This is good. This is what we expected. The next thing is, does this coil produce something, any electromagnetic field? Therefore, we have another probe. This is the waveform. So we activate this channel here. We can reduce this a little, bring it up. And now we check the electromagnetic field above the coil. You see the pink? The closer I get to the coil, the stronger the signal gets. Okay, it's a mixed signal. There might be several overtones, probably some noise, because the coil is way too small for this frequency. It emits something, but it's not in resonant. But at least something comes out. You see it. The closer I get, the stronger the signal. And you see, when this is the maximum, I can even increase this, but let's leave it like this. So when you just 2 centimeters, it already decreases drastically. And then 20 centimeters or more. So this means close to the device, we have the radiation. The more you get away, the more it fades. But this goes with any other antenna. Close to the antenna, we have a strong signal. And the more you move away, the signal drops. I don't know what these frequencies are. Doesn't matter. At least something comes out of this thing. I mean, the quality is not bad. I like this little switch for the display. Looks professional. And in this video, I won't repeat what the benefit of these Schumann frequencies are. In my first video, I told you about them. Probably you know them better than me. And now comes the question. Does this really work? Or is it just another placebo, it's hard to decide. First, the waves are very, very minuscule. For example, your cell phone or your Wi-Fi router has way more power. And how strong the natural Schumann frequencies are, it's hard to measure. And then something else comes. Some people like raspberries, other people are allergic. Not everybody accepts any food or any stress or any frequency. Some people, they smoke their whole life and they live long, and other people die early with lung cancer. What was the problem between both? It's way more difficult with all these parameters. Therefore, I would say, when you're interested, test it out. People said, this works. Other people say, this doesn't work. Some people say, I like this film. And the next person says, this film is absolutely nonsense. And the next thing is our mental vibrations in case of placebo effect. When I think this works, probably it works. When I think this doesn't work, probably it doesn't work for me, but for another person. Some people hear voices, others not. Some people get inspirations to become a millionaire, others not. It's way more complicated than we think. But at least I can say this thing does what it promises. It generates sine waves. They look quite good. The output is stable. We hear a clear sine wave, and the same frequency goes in the coil. Something is emitting what I don't know. Because these frequencies are so low. We're not talking on the audio sound. We're talking on electromagnetic waves. And to measure all the overtones and their field strength, this takes a lot of equipment. And only very big laboratories or universities have this. Which means, even if this looks good, it is still a mystery box. And I would say, you have to find out whether it works for you or not. Thank you so much for watching. I made some brainwave experiments with a real generator. No, this one, I have another one. And I put all the Schumann frequency videos in a playlist. I will put the playlist in the description. And when you have something to share about the benefits or no benefits, please write it in the comments. Let's learn from each other. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll meet you in another video.